What's going on, everybody? It's David Palmer, the Leo King, and welcome to episode 3 of Hanging with the Leo King. Now, I know I brought up in the last episode that we were going to talk more about astrology and kind of go more behind the scenes, and trust me, in this episode, we're going to get there. But this episode is all about learning to let go. Now, David, who's behind the camera, him and I are here at Sutra Nightclub tonight, and I'm DJing for a holiday party here. And this episode's really all about learning to let go. I think we're all coming into the end of the 2015 into 2016, like, what in the hell's going on? And there's like this angst inside. There's this feeling inside that, you know, you gotta step up. And when you, that feeling of stepping up isn't easy. Whether you gotta step up and help your mom or whether you gotta step up and DJ at the last minute. Like, I literally got called here the last minute to DJ and I have to promote and I have to put it on Instagram and Twitter and on my YouTube and on my Facebook and I have to get it out to as many people as I can and get people here. There's a lot of pressure with that. And I think what I'm trying to say is this episode is going to be all about not so much about the DJing and not so much about what I'm doing here at the club tonight, but the releasing, letting go. Right now, I think we're all at a place where we just need to let go. We all just need to let our energy to say, what the fuck? You know why? Because at the end of the day, we have no control over what's going on. We're all coming into this year with not our best energy. And this is a time, just like in Risky Business, where he literally puts on, I think I got my sunglasses on me, actually. You know, and he's like, you know, when he looks at the guy from, I think it's like Harvard or it's Princeton or whatever, and he says, sometimes you just gotta say, what the fuck? And you know what? I think right now, and especially today, I'm just saying, what the fuck? I promoted my butt off to get this thing. I literally hit up everybody on all social media, over 30,000 people, and literally it was hard to get people here. And you know what? I have to say, what the fuck? I have to say, you know what? Sometimes things don't work out the way that you want to. Some nights I can get 20, 50, 100 people, and sometimes I can only get a couple. But you know what? At the end of the day, I think it's all about learning to release and let go. And this episode is gonna be about releasing and letting go, and especially how I'm dealing with the end of this year, 2015, which has been brutal and hard. And you're gonna see it behind with me at the club and me in my studio and me doing astrology, me doing a commercial and all these things that I'm doing right now. So I hope you enjoy episode 3, learning to release in every part of life. Thanks so much. I'll see you guys inside. Up, Siri. How we doing? We live?
Yeah, we live.
Okay. Well, tonight was actually one of the best nights I've had in a long time. And you know, this whole episode is about going with the flow. And I gotta tell you, Everything worked out. I got to see friends that I hadn't seen in a while. People were working out. I met an awesome spiritual guy who was literally at the table right next to us, who does massaging and chakra healing and all this stuff. I was like, I can't even believe this. And then it ended with me being extremely hungry. And out of nowhere, the guy who was sitting at the table next to us had just got a pizza and was like, hey, here's some pizza. It's like the universe provides 100% whenever you need it. Whenever you need it. It's crazy, you know? So now that it's after the show, it's time to check the social media. See how that's going. A lot of people are asleep though, it's late. And it's a school night. DJing on a school night is not the same as DJing on a weekend, you know? People are asleep right now. But it was a good night overall. And you know what? Going with the flow sometimes really has an extremely awesome benefit. And anyway, felt good.
Toys for Tots.
Yeah, we helped people with Toys for Tots, and it was a charity event, and things just went perfect. So we'll see how things go with my astrology land. What's up, guys? So, I'm here at the Leo King office now to give you guys a little behind the scene of hanging out with me. This is episode 3 about going with the flow, and also what I do here in my office, how I do the Leo King channel, how I do the apps, how I do all the horoscopes, how I shoot the videos. This is where it goes down. Now, before I got this office, believe it or not, I used to do it outside on a laptop. I would just find a tree, or I'd find some random place and I'd do it. Then I upgraded and I got a Canon camera, which is now a historical item. It's a menu item, or it's like a museum item now. I almost lost the crowd there. Look at it, it's got dust on it. This Canon was my first. I remember when I got this, I thought that this was like the most amazing thing that had ever been made in the world. I truly did. But it's now a museum piece. It actually still works. I wonder if there's even a card in here. No. But that's how crazy it was. So I used to use this camera, and then I used to go on this lake. If you guys remember me, I used to go on a lake. And I'll put a little image of it right now. But I used to do the horoscopes on the lake for like almost a year. It's kind of how I got found. That's where I created the Leo King. And then I upgraded to a green screen, and I did the green screen when I moved to Hollywood, and for the last couple years I lived in Hollywood, and I had the green screen in my living room. And so my living room was an office. It was kind of like, it was not easy to bring girls over. It's like, hi, welcome to my house. Yeah, oh, the computer's the TV, and the dining room is a green screen. So that kind of didn't work out too long, and I felt cramped because it was like, I was doing readings, I was doing horoscopes, I was doing everything in the space of my living quarters, which was very difficult to do. But after that, I finally moved back to Orange County so I could have an office and I could separate my home and my office, even though I did have a little studio in my garage for a little minute there in Orange County before I got this. But now this is it, so I'll give you guys a little bit of a tour here. This is the TV where we put a lot of stuff on. Like, I'll check the horoscopes, make sure I'll airplay it through Apple or whatever to see what's going on the TV. I'm thinking about getting rid of this desk. This is for the invisible secretary that I don't have, if you didn't know. This is, the Leo King couch, and where this is, people sit here, people hang out here, and, and then I'll show you guys my desk and the DJ equipment. So this is the DJ area. This is where I practice and do a lot of my DJ stuff for spiritualdancemusic.com, the other part of the Leo King Network. Believe it or not, this whole entire system is on wheels, so I can move this anywhere I want to go. It was custom made by my stepdad, Roger Hickey. And so I could pretty much move this anywhere I want to go. It's on wheels because I actually don't do the live show here. I do it in the green screen studio, which I'll show you in a second. But this is where I hang out and do that. And then this is my desk. This is the desk where I do all my readings. This is where I do the horoscopes. I do all the editing of the videos. I know I need to get stuff on the wall. I know it's lagging. But actually, the stuff I want to get on the wall is, this is my first DJ mixer. An old Stanton. It doesn't even have knobs on it anymore in work, and it's all, oh, it's a rusty bucket now. But that's one thing I want to get on the wall. And then before I had the money to get a Pioneer mixer, I bought a Behringer. Any DJ knows, but don't buy Behringer. But you know what? It got me to where I am today. And believe it or not, this thing was state-of-the-art like 7 years, 7, 8 years ago. This thing was like the shit. Now it's a bucket of bolts, but you know, you gotta go and work someplace on it. This is my gun in case anybody wants to mess with the Leo King, even though it's just a BB gun. So I guess let's check out the green screen studio now, and I'll show you guys where I do the horoscopes. So this is the green screen studio area. This is where I keep all the equipment, all the toys, all the shooting equipment, you know, all the wires, everything that we do here. This is kind of where I stage and set up. This is where I keep some equipment here. And then this is the green screen studio. This thing was custom built by me, believe it or not. It was not easy because my old green screen studio was just a piece of cloth that was in the background. But I wanted a 180 degree rounded green screen studio. So, you know, I could set up the DJ equipment and do the show much easier instead of like having to barely make it in. It was so hard to do spiritual dance music online before I had a wide enough area. But basically, I just come here, set up, turn the lights on, move them around. It's kind of cool because you can kind of customize this green screen, do whatever you want. It's kind of a mess. I got wires all over the floor and whatever. But this is where I do it. I even insulated the top, and there's actually lights back up inside the framing here that I did. So it's got a lot of lights. And that's why, you know, I can make it pop real good is the lighting. But pretty much this is my life and what I do. And so while I'm setting up, why don't we talk about letting go. So today, I have to record all the horoscopes for the app, which is 21 horoscopes, believe it or not. I do a week. That's excluding the uncut. The uncut's 22. And whatever Leo King talks I do on YouTube as well are excluded. But trust me, it's an anxiety disorder just trying to always get all these videos done every week, and I gotta edit them. And make sure they're good. You know, one thing about being an astrologer is you gotta be good every week. There's not a week where you're like, oh, I kind of was off. I really wasn't good with the horoscope this week. Because you could lose a lot of people quick. So there's a little bit of pressure being an astrologer because people are always like going, did that come true in my life? Is that real? And I think with letting go, especially being an astrologer, we'll use me as an example, is I really have to trust that the information I provide and I put out is divinely guided by the universe and God, and that you can just trust that it's going to come out right. So I don't actually trip that, was that good enough, or are people going to really believe that? It's not even like that, because I don't even do astrology like, are they going to believe what I'm saying? It's not even like that. It's more like, I'm just divinely here to give you this message, and this is from a higher source, and that's just what it is, you know? So, you know, it's not a very simple thing, you know? It really isn't. But, so, I have many cameras that I have in my arsenal. For the horoscopes, I like using the 70D.
because I like a DSLR look for the green screen. I'll just be real. The camera that's being used right now is my high-end TV camera, but I use that for more documentary stuff, live shoots when I'm out doing DJing, and I use that for the uncut. But for some reason, I don't like the way that that camera does the green screen. I like the DSLR better for green screen stuff. So for any tech nerds out there trying to get into green screen, I definitely recommend this camera. The 70D is the only camera that Canon has that has full dual tracking. So that means you could do autofocus on this. And it also is the only touch screen and where the screen flips out towards you. So I've been doing this alone for a lot of years. So for me, it's been a big deal to have to see how it comes out. See how it comes out while I'm looking at it, which is sometimes not easy, right? If you don't understand what I'm meaning is, when I get behind there, I want to be able to see how I look in frame. And so that's why I like this camera. Even though that camera does that too, I think if you want to get into this, buy a camera that has, if you want to do it yourself, has the ability to flip the screen out towards you and see what you're doing. Because most of the time I'm by myself, and most of the time I'm shooting by myself. And so sometimes, that's what I have to do. The other thing that I recommend highly is getting really good audio. Audio on YouTube, and especially to even have an app where people are going to pay you money and watch it, like a TV network. If you don't have good audio, you're basically going to... Nobody's going to watch you. The problem with most of the YouTube astrologers, I'd say 90%, is they all have horrible audio. They're using, crappy audio. And nobody wants to hear it when it's that bad. Because it doesn't pierce and hit your ears good. So I use the Sennheiser, I think this is the 300 EW or whatever, 300 series. It's expensive, but it's worth the money. It's worth every penny. And it took me a while to save up for all this stuff. It took me 3.5 years to save up for it, but at the end of the day, it all turned out right. Basically, that's pretty much it. The next thing I do after I get all set up here is I have to look at the astrology. Now, doing the astrology is a whole different animal. But for shits and giggles, let me just... You can't have the green too bright in the background. Yeah, that's pretty much go. Oh, this is off. Here we go. I also have these little lights that are kind of underneath that kind of help. They kind of add to giving me light. It's kind of a secret. I also have a light above me, too, on my head to highlight my head. Doing green screen, I would recommend buying a green screen book. I actually learned off an old book from 2006. And it took me one day to figure it all out, but... So once I got this set, I do the astrology, and we'll go do that right now, and I'll show you guys how I do it at the office. So this is where I do the horoscopes. So I'm a PC nerd. I am. But I do have an Apple. I had to actually get an Apple eventually. But the thing about astrology and charts. One, astro.com is amazing. So it's an HTML, it's a web-based server. You can do it anywhere. You can do it on your cell phone, an Apple, a PC, whatever. Now, I use astro.com in readings. I use astro.com all the time. But believe it or not, I do not use astro.com for the horoscopes. I use Solarfire. So I use an actual astrology program. And that the reason why I use Solar Fire is, number one, you can scan through the minutes, the day. It's got this clock feature that's literally like an astrology clock. It's amazing. It's beautiful. The other aspect is you can run reports on the energy with all the elements and the strengths and solar eclipses and so many more things that are more detailed for an astrologer through Solar Fire. So I recommend if you are an astrologer and you don't have a astrology program, I'd get one. It's difficult for Apple. I think Apple has time passages or whatever, but that's a crappy program. I'm just going to be honest with you. Sorry. Ooh. Maybe they want to sponsor me one day and I'm totally ruining the sponsorship, but I personally like Solar Fire and I like Windstar. I used to actually represent Windstar for fun because one of my good buddies, Michael Erlewine, started Windstar, but then he sold it, so that's kind of changed. But I would say that Solar Fire is my favorite program out of all of them. Oh, and of course there was an update on Windows. We've updated your PC. Blah, 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 blah. So. It's going to take a second. I also have it on my Apple, but on Apple, you have to actually get a Windows, I forgot what it's called, and I'm a computer nerd. I use something called Parallels, which allows me to run Windows on my Apple, and it's the best one because you could be running both simultaneously. So if you want, I'll show you. Sorry, that's Angelina in bed. Sorry, Brad, I'm looking at your girl. So you can run Parallels. You can go into Windows. I definitely recommend, if you have an Apple, to have Windows on your Apple. You can do 15,000 million more things on Windows than you can Apple. And I'm a PC nerd, so... gonna show you the rest of that pin. Okay, here we go. So, because I don't know, okay, here we go, Solar Fire. Okay, so what's cool about Solar Fire, no, cancel, okay, animate. So it'll show you the astrology of today, and you can change it by minutes, hours, seconds. It's amazing. So for me, when I do my horoscopes, I do it at noon. So let's turn the hours and go to noon. Because I like to see a day chart. Now in astrology, there's day charts and there's night charts. Night chart means you were born at night and the sun's at the bottom of the chart. And you'll usually see a lot of planets down there too. Day charts, of course, are when the sun's at the top. I run a day chart because, of course, I'm trying to get the middle of the day. Now, it's very difficult being an astrologer and doing it in the world because Australians get confused. Australians seem to think that, for some reason, they're a day ahead. They're not a day ahead. The calendar says they're a day ahead. But when I'm looking at noon on December... Let's say so I'm doing the 21st for this week, so let's go to days. Let me go to the 21st. Okay, so when I'm doing it for noon on the 21st of December, that horoscope is going to be the same for you in Australia on the 22nd at, let's say, 8 a.m. or something, okay? It's not that you're ahead. It's not that I'm, you know, that you're behind on the horoscope. You just need to do the math in your own head. So I think a lot of Australians and Europeans and people on the other side of the globe get so confused and feel like they're behind or that I'm like not thinking of them, when I think you just need to understand how time works. And that's all astrology is, it's about time. Of course, I wanted to use my big nice screen here, but Windows is updating. It just did a big update right now, right when I'm trying to do this video. But basically, this is where I do it. Now, I do it for the week, so when I do, we'll do this. How about this? Okay. So, I don't know if you can see this on here. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know why the screen is so white.
Dark it. Yep, no, up a little more. Right there.
All right. So, when I do the chart, I do it for the week. So I just look at all 7 days, of course. And I basically, I take each day very seriously for when I do the sun sign horoscopes, because I want to be able to see what the whole week's going to bring. But,
it'll take it. There it goes. You just had to zoom in a little bit.
So, it's cool because I really take each day seriously. Believe it or not, I look at the week and I do the sun sign horoscopes first. Then I come back individually each day again. And I do that because when I do the individual horoscopes, I want to be in a different energy. So I actually like kind of in my own energy field, I use my own energy. Like I literally, I don't know, I do it in different waves, I guess. So it's a very weird thing, doing astrology horoscopes and researching the astrology and setting it all up and doing all the editing and doing it all out of here. But I recommend separating your home and your work. I had to learn that lesson very deeply, because when you are entrenched in spirituality from your home, and you're dealing with everybody looking at your energy, and you're dealing with, you know, higher forms of frequencies. Because at the end of the day, whether you want to call them spirits, angels, you know, you're dealing with frequency. And so you want to be able to come to a place where your body and your human body adapts to different frequencies differently, so it gets comfortable with it. I don't want these frequencies in my home. When I'm at my home, it's like I want my PlayStation, I want my cat. And I want a beautiful home where, you know, if I take a girl back to the house or something, it's like beautiful and it feels good. And there's not like, you know, all these crazy frequencies going on about like people going through, you know, some crazy Saturn transit or some Uranian energy coming and sparking you. Like there's something about the fourth house that has a shell and a protection, and the 10th house does not. And so I think that having this place, Leo King Studios, allows the horoscopes to be better, because I am able to go hibernate and come to this place and adjust to the frequency level better. And I think going with the flow, because that's what the whole point of this is it's not always going to be perfect the way that things come out, or the time in which I'm going to do the horoscopes and how they're going to come. Like, it's all on a natural cycle. And I think it's important to pay attention to that cycle. And because you'll actually end up exactly where you want to be. So thanks for joining me here at Leo King Studios, and joining me in kind of a little behind the scenes and how I do it and what I do here. And I appreciate you watching this episode, hanging with the Leo King. And of course, we'll see you on the next episode.